So I'm here with at Hove Lagoon. I'm going to be speaking to Councillor Robert Nemeth, Conservative Councillor for the Wish Ward on Brighton Hove City Council, as well as Nicholas Dexter, who is a landscape gardener and designer for this episode of The Vote. We're here at Hove Lagoon. We're going to be talking about the community gardens, which are just beyond me there on the other side of the lagoon. We're also going to be talking about Lagoon Fest, so hope you enjoy the show. So here with Nicholas Dexter, who is a landscape designer, who's responsible for this scheme here, and with the Conservative Councillor Robert Nemeth for the Wish Ward. Nicholas, tell us about the scheme behind us. It's a community in action, right? It's a community getting involved and revitalising Hove Lagoon. Tell us all about it.
Yeah, I mean, it's been years in the planning. I suppose we've gone through certain consultation processes to get to this point, but it was a very proud moment to sort of see it planted last week. So. It's still early days for the plants. We've chosen plants that are sort of coastal tolerant and should survive, but we've been suffering sort of quite, not suffering, but there's been quite a lot of hot weather recently, which has meant the community has had to spring into action to keep them alive in the first week.
Yeah, and what have we got here then? The perennial plants, I think we've got here?
Yeah, mostly perennials and grasses. So, I mean, the perennials are best for this situation because you can cut them back hard after strong coastal winds have occurred in, you know, through the winter months. And they should come back nice and fresh. But they're already starting to flower, which is great, and they should attract a lot of wildlife, which is one of the key aims of the project.
Yeah, exactly. Bees, is that key here to attract bees and other pollinators, Robert?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, 100% for bees. Can I tell you the background?
Go for it.
So it started when a kind resident, about 5 years ago, offered to plant up one of the banks with tulips. And I brought a local gardener down here, and she said, guys, you could be so much more ambitious. You know, you'd be crazy to just waste your gardening efforts on just planting up one bank with tulips. You need something that survives in the sea air, something that's a lot more colourful, comes up at different times. And I thought, I know just the man who could help us, famous in the area for helping with various seafront projects, and Nicholas Dexter would be best person. So Nick's helped us now for probably feels like four or five years.
I think it's been 4 or 5 years, yeah.
Which has absolutely flown by. And it's taken this sort of time to consult the community. The scheme's changed absolutely loads from Nick's first sketches. We've had all sorts of big changes along the way. We've had to save the money.
Yeah.
This sort of scheme's not cheap. Maintaining it's not cheap. Building a team up who can actually plant it, who can maintain it, because it has to be community led, or it's not going to get looked after. Everyone has to be behind it. And then we've had to, as the Friends of Hove Lagoon, which is what I chair, we've had to, you know, collectively learn how a planting scheme works. We've had two great leads on it, which is Tom Steer and Chris Flint. They've been phenomenal. We've had to appoint an actual landscape gardener to do the work, Dan Borman.
Yeah.
So to build this team up and get support, raise funds, Rampion Wind Farm, all the local businesses, has been quite a
project. How is it funded then? Because obviously it's a voluntary scheme, but obviously you need to buy the plants.
Well, so funding has come in all sorts of ways. Lots of people have given their time freely, you know, or a massively discounted rate, and they've done it without people being generous, you know, fully backing us. The big funds have come from Rampion Wind Farm. They've given us a big grant. Lots of the local businesses here, Big Beach Cafe, the Pirate Guys, Lagoon Water Sports, Gather In, Cheese Man, Fish, Shore and Port Authority, they've all chipped in towards our Lagoon Fest pot. That's ultimately funded from the community side. And then lots of donations, you know, all the sorts of things we run, like the tombolas and things like that.
Yeah.
That has ultimately gone towards this project.